I dedicate this video to the community that I love. And that includes you as well, Shields.
What's the point of wasting your energy when you could just go play a whole nother game and just forget about the game if it's so trash, if it's so trash and boo-boo, buggy and all that stuff? Then, you know, I would just leave it alone. That's what I would do.
If you were capable of independent thought, I wouldn't have to explain to you what constructive criticism is.
I wish this game was better than this, I really do. I take no pleasure in the Avengers game being such an underwhelming waste of everyone's time and money.
Breaking into the same bases, fighting the same enemies, now the developers have had to admit the fact that this game has been a crazy abysmal failure.
It's not very often we see quite the high profile failure so publicly documented with some population data to boot.
Avengers lost 96% of its players.
It regularly dips below 500 players nowadays, and today it hit an all-time low of just 386 players.
Consumers, gamers, fans, and people in general deserve better. And to make damn sure fiascos like these are not forgotten, so that the industry does not repeat itself.
Most insane villain!
Kamala Khan from the Avengers game!
Yo, this evil queen took over the whole fucking game!
Come on! They did it, Dia. I was wrong the whole time. I've been saying there weren't enough villains.
Shut up, get this f***ing little kid out of here. I want to be the Hulk.
Even 15-year-old girls who are fans of the Avengers don't want to play as a 15-year-old girl who is fans of the Avengers.
Worst game of the year. Marvel's Avengers. Let's hear it for
Crystal Dynamics and Square Enix's Avengers. An empty skeleton of a title treating the Avengers IP as bankable regardless of what's actually on offer.
When even Crystal Dynamics admits that there are thousands of bugs that need fixing in so profound a capacity that bug fixes have been prioritized, pushing DLC neatly out of this year to the point where 4 months after launch, all you have to show for DLC in your $60 game is a girl archer and a mode with a timer.
Then they just crap out something unbalanced and unfinished that they have to spend their time apologizing for and fixing instead of building upon.
Unpolished, incomplete, lifeless, and does not show signs that the publisher and or developers are willing to respect the money and time of the players.
Instead of just giving you a lot of cool costumes for free, they throw them in a real money shot. And these are at prices that would make a free-to-play game blush in a game that you paid $60 for.
Still buggy enough to halt progress, extremely bad rewards across the board on all missions, unlock skins still reverting to being locked, emotes but no emote wheel in a $60 game with $14 skins and $12 takedowns. You're dishonest, and furthermore, you're a shill. You're so desperate for access that you'll forever foolishly refuse to acknowledge the mountain of faults and game-breaking issues that didn't just make it difficult for some people to play, it made it impossible.
There's been a lack of communication from Square Enix about fixing all the issues with the game. Its subreddit is full of posts about various problems that players have encountered.
So this is one of the many bugs that are going on in the game right now. A lot of the daily missions just don't work for people. I haven't been able to complete my daily villain sectors in over a week and a half.
Out there who only want to hear positivity, you call the truth negative, doesn't mean it's wrong. It's still the truth, bro. You just don't like it. Just be honest with yourself and make these games better.
Just because your shill ass is paid to ignore the reality of the game's current state doesn't mean people should just stop playing if they don't like
it.
One
of the biggest problems a lot of people had with it was Kamala Khan. They didn't like her very much. They thought she was annoying.
Is this really happening?
I'm Iron Man.
Indeed.
I am Iron Man.
In one of my stories, Iron Man has to shoot out a bunch
of...
I mean, I just flew on a Quinjet to a secret shield base. We saw Nick Fury, and now I'm talking to Jarvis and not keeping my cool at all.
What are we supposed to do but hate this bitch?
You might look at her and say, this is a singularly unappealing character. Oh, she stretches like Plastic Man or Mr. Fantastic.
I think it's absolutely insane that Kamala is actually going to be in one of the biggest Marvel games that we've done.
Focusing on Kamala Khan, the amazing human diversity quota, attending an Avengers convention and just totally impressing the shoulder pads off of several poorly dressed smug white dudes with her obsequious fangirling. It's about as excruciating as it sounds, and not a little Mary Suey.
She's a very recent addition to the Marvel Universe. She was only invented about 6 years ago.
So you choose this recently made character to be the focal point of your video game.
Dude, I feel you.
Dude, I feel you. Is that phrase old enough to drink? It would have taken you only 2 seconds to jump on TikTok and see what little motherfuckers are saying these days, but nope.
The story focused on Miss Marvel rather than telling a concrete story about every Avenger.
You've bought an Avengers game where you've played Thor for a sum total of 10 minutes and spent the rest of the time playing a walking archetype who isn't an Avenger.
Experience the Avengers through the unbearably irritating lens of a Marvel superfan.
Even she started to get cringy and grating. Kamala, please. Honestly, I wanted it to be more about, I don't know, the Avengers.
You're so simple that you can't process that Marvel's Avengers, still a two-villain on repeat, one enemy faction having zero Marvel location boasting live service with broken dailies, a looter with loot so bad that the blues outstat the exotics, that exotics have a capacity to drop with no perks, enemies still spawning under the map to the point where you gotta keep reloading in the hopes that things will work this time, skins you pay money for that are still relocking themselves, $14 skins in your $60 game, a campaign that you can only play once after 4 months.
The game should just change its name to The Averagers. Unless your idea of fun is painting the same wall, the same color, but switching the direction from up to down, I don't know how this is going to hold you for very long.
If you're looking for a repetitive, boring game that makes you do the same thing over and over and over again, then this is the game for you.
Uninteresting environments and enemies. You're revisiting these places endlessly. Other games as a service games just do a better job. You know, variety within it being the same thing.
Jump into the extremely repetitive gameplay loop where you'll punch things or stand in circles on 4 whole different levels.
Enjoy your loyalty to whatever brand that currently owns you. They own you so hard they dictate your opinions and what you can and cannot say. And know this, as a black man, it saddens me to see you act so shamefully.
Oh wow, you get to fight all these villains. Those two are the only Marvel supervillains you fight in the game besides the final boss. That's ridiculous.
Generic robots, even for boss fights, because that's what you want in a Marvel game. Fuck the supervillains, you want robots and AIM scientists. And AIM robots.
But could we not fight more than just robots and AIM soldiers? Why are we stuck fighting in Utah, a snowy tundra, a forest, and a city? Here, it's just the same generic biomes over and over.
Future expansions, those are actually going to come with new biomes, with whole new areas, new geography.
Biomes were coming? As if any Marvel fan is interested or excited about biomes, people want Asgard, Atlantis, Wakanda, space locations, etc. But you're willfully ignorant.
One of the best things about Ultimate Alliance 3 was this roller coaster feeling of flying through a who's who of Marvel's best locations and characters.
Remember Marvel's Ultimate Alliance where every boss fight was a classic Marvel villain? Oh, you wanted to fight Bullseye? Ultimo? The Wrecking Crew? Nah, how about Warbot? How about Warship?
People didn't like the character designs. They thought they didn't look enough, I guess, like the movies or the comic books.
UGLY. These Avengers got no alibi. They ugly. And before the apologists defend this trash and make it seem like the problem is that they don't look like their MCU counterparts from the movies, that's not the problem. The problem is that they're ugly.
The problem isn't that they don't look like their on-screen counterparts. The problem is that they're real fucking ugly.
Character models aren't all that stellar or impressive in-game, especially Tony Stark, who looks like some random NPC. Tony Stark looks like an NPC I'd find in the streets of Ubisoft's Watch Dogs or something.
Paul Tassi. Contribute to why does Crystal Dynamics Avengers game look so weird? Pretty cool of Marvel to give the stunt doubles their own game. It looks cheap, looks rushed, looks like something you'd find at a dollar store, like a mobile game equivalent. Looks like a Chinese knockoff, and that's not a racially charged comment, YouTube. China has a long-running history of not giving a fuck as it pertains to breaking off a piece of that intellectual Kit Kat bar. You've heard of Kit Kat, but have you heard of Kit Kat? Here's the kicker. I don't want this shit.
The Avengers player base has been asking for some kind of roadmap for the future. Instead, they've gotten mostly crickets.
Yeah, guys, soon, I know. Soon TM.
We're gonna make soon into a nameplate also, I think.
You're gonna make a soon nameplate? Will you delay that one too, like you did the Sarah Garza one? Since nameplates are too complicated for you to smoothly implement into your game. No joke, that happened.
As Hawkeyes. Two Hawkeyes.
They're giving us two Hawkeye-style characters back-to-back, and that's a move.
With only two villains, no Marvel locations, poor communication, no roadmap, and stupid decisions like making two archers the first choices for DLC heroes, it's clear that this game is in a losing fight with itself.
It's a game that felt old, and really out of touch with current gaming trends, expectations, design philosophies, and realities.
You telling me the devs that's working on the game can't see that it's not a finished product? So they put out a skin, they're like,
oh, we're terribly sorry. Accept our apology and get a free skin out the store.
Very generous of you to issue challenge points as compensation for our frustration. But when you realize that the challenge card levels are often populated with palette swap skins or pictures of locations, why didn't you just give us the money?
You really have to hold these devs accountable. Devs have been getting away for the past 2 years with some foolishness.
This game has suffered a death blow, self-inflicted, and it's on life support right now. And the potential for recovery depended greatly on selecting a direction significantly less foolish than this. It depended on the preservation of good faith among players you failed to retain with non-existent communication. Players who are well within their right to be upset with broken promises and a defective product.
I had less crashes upon release than I do now, and from keeping an eye on Reddit and other places, I know I'm not the only one with that experience.
Every single time I went to boot up the game, it couldn't make it past the first loading screen. And guess what? It did it again, didn't it? Except this time, it straight up told me to delete the game and reinstall.
You're disgusting enough to imply that we're not sympathetic because...
Sometimes we lose devs because of forest fires in California. People have to evacuate their homes. That's actually happened several times. We've had power failures, we've had people lose internet.
I thought this game was in development for 5 years. The buggy garbage you delivered on launch is deserving of the near $50 million loss. You had years to develop this game, but we're the jerks for calling out this mess that you charged $60 for because fires? Listen. Most of us didn't want to pay to be beta testers for your bucket of crap, and even though some gamers have goldfish memory, they're starting to remember how far $60 can actually go.
We refunded our second and third review copies immediately. We all suggested, we're like, let's refund this as quick as possible.
Marvel Ultimate Alliance has more personality than this game, and that's a game where you literally do just mash one button. This game does not have its own identity. And it shows.
Marvel's Avengers keeps finding ways to drag itself down. At times, it almost feels like it goes out of its way to do so.
It doesn't have near the differentiation, the diversity of any other game in its sphere right now.
Visualizing things is important, so Arkham Asylum released in 2009, here's what their villains looked like. Here's Spider-Man from 2018, this is what the villains in that game look like. Here was Destiny, launched in 2016, 4 years ago, homie. The failure extends to your lack of communication with a fan base overflowing with fanboys and ball slurpers that would inhale your farts and tell you they're fresh cinnamon rolls, but you sabotage the goodwill that you needed to make this live service a success by hitting us with this soon. And not only that, but it's like a joke.
We're gonna make soon into a nameplate also, I think.
I could cut together these clips to the end of time, but shills, defenders, I appreciate your closed-minded foolishness and hope you know you're a bigger motivator in continuing to make these videos than anyone. The internet is not the safe space you want it to be, and you don't get to decide that something is hate just because it isn't positive or praise. We are entitled to free speech. We are paying customers with the right to motivate the industry into a better position. Just because you accept whatever you're given on your knees doesn't mean that we are forced to as well. The combat in this game is explosively well done when it works, and I have always contributed that as my positive thing that I like about this game. It's the only reason that this game could potentially have a future, with players anticipating their actual favorite hero in this game if it ever gets all of the archers out of its system. With the countless suggestions for modes and features that I've personally submitted, it should be clear that I'm one of the biggest proponents of change in this entire community. And thanks to you shills, I'm one of the few honest people still covering this. Thank you for watching. Share your opinion, whether positive or negative, because I don't demand or expect an echo chamber in my comment section or anywhere on the internet while maintaining the dismissal of reasonable stances. No brand cracks a whip at my back. And the true sickness of what I observe in the shills that make up this community is that they're willfully submitting to their unpaid NPC duty. Lovers, haters, subscribe to me. And the second that this title actually gets something worth praising, I will be the first to positively reinforce that decision. Because positive reinforcement is what brings about change. Not people whacking away because if you don't like it, then don't play it. Shut up, boy. How dumb. How dumb. People. Workers. Are risking their lives going face to face with maskless, selfishly negligent morons, encouraged by a president who, after making fun of the new president, caught the virus himself. Why? Because they don't have a choice. They need food. They need a roof over their heads. And in many of these people's cases, they have people to support. They only have and make enough to make it to the next paycheck. And if they got sick, they could only afford to die. But they do their job without the luxurious safety net of knowing they'll be able to keep it when they habitually fuck up. Y'all made a Marvel game with two villains? Three if we're counting the single player that you can only play once and then can't replay after 2 months of this game being out. Actually, it's 4 months now. Y'all better hope the next patch has a loot overhaul and drops two heroes at the same time, since only one person can play the new hero. You better hope they drop three villains at the same time. Are you getting the picture? This game is playing catch up to a game that it needed to be at launch and needs to have been building upon now. It dead. See you later.